These are just some of my favorite horror films. This is an awesome version of Halloween. I love this Blu-ray. Sleepaway Camp. Can't go wrong with Sleepaway Camp. It's a classic in my opinion. Great film. Ginger Snaps. Awesome werewolf film. Definitely glad that I own this. And Stephen King's Silver Bullet, my favorite Stephen King film adaptation. I know not a lot of people are big fans of it. But I personally am a big fan, and these are just kind of four of my favorite horror films.
Hey guys, so I'm about to go to the movies and see this new horror film called The Wench Killer. I hope it's good. There's so many remakes nowadays and so much unoriginality in horror now that I hope it's something new and fresh. As you can see in the background here, I fucking love horror films, and I personally think I am the biggest horror fangirl out there. Hey guys, so as I said in my previous video, I was going to the movies to see The Wench Killer, and I actually just got back, and let me tell you guys, it was fucking awesome. Any idiot who says on YouTube that it fucking sucks and is shitting on it has no idea what the fuck they're talking about. The killer, he was very interesting because he broke people's jaws with a wrench. I know I'm not, that's all I'm gonna really say about it. I don't wanna go into deep great detail because I don't want to spoil the whole thing, and the surprise ending was fucking awesome too. I was not expecting that. The detective was probably one of my favorite parts too, and if you haven't already figured it out, it is a slasher film, so if you like it, great. If you like slasher films, great. If you don't like slasher films, I mean, you should still check it out. It's a pretty great film, but I definitely highly recommend this to you guys if you haven't seen it yet, and if you are a big fan of slasher films like I am, as you can see, yeah, you should really check it out. And oh, there's this guy on here that is going around shitting on this film, saying it sucks. Don't listen to him. He has no fucking idea what he is talking about, and yeah, just don't listen to anybody who shits on this film, because it is an awesome film, and I adore this film. Like, it is probably one of my favorite films right now. But yeah, thank you guys for tuning in, and like I said, don't listen to that guy. He is fucking clueless and has no idea what he's talking about. Who is it?
Man, Miss Detective Powell, I'd like to get you to come to the door. Well, I want to ask you a couple of questions.
Yes?
Yes, ma'am, I'm sorry to bother you, but there's been a string of murders going around. They're based on this wrench killer, this movie. We think it's linked, whatever, so we're just trying to ask a few questions.
I have nothing to offer you guys. This is crazy. Now, if I'm not under arrest, I'd like to get some sleep. I have a big day at work tomorrow.
Sorry to bother you.
So, horror movies this year just haven't been very good. I mean, I don't even think Jason over here could even think of a good one. It's like The Wrench Killer. I just got done seeing that this weekend, and it was horrible. It was the worst movie I've seen all year, and that was the most anticipated horror film of the year. I can't even believe how horrible it was. But Jason also saw it. What is your thoughts on that movie, Jason?
It was beyond predictable, not scary, and in all honesty, it's one of the worst horror movies I have ever seen in my life. Wait, there it was again! What the fuck, man? What the fuck's going on? Wait, there it was again! What the fuck, man? What the fuck's going on?
Welcome back. Right now, with a wrench in the mouth, be pending an investigation.
Serves people right for shitting on this brilliant movie. No, seriously, I'm just kidding. But whoever is doing this sure is a big fan of this movie. I've looked on YouTube on many different videos and just searching, trying to figure out who else likes this movie besides me, and there really aren't that many people out there who like this movie. I did see, though, that there is this guy who said he was gonna see the movie too, and after I did some investigating, it turned out that he wound up dead, which is very strange. Hello? Yes. You know how a couple years ago there was a killing related to the original Wrench Killer? I wanted to know if the killer was in fact my biological mother, and if you'd let me know as soon as possible, that would be lovely. Thank you. Wait, you're telling me that she's my biological mother? Wait, are you kidding me right now? Holy shit. All right, I have to go. Am I the killer? I don't know what to think about this right now. I really need to find out if I fucking kill those people or not. I can't think of any explanation or reason. I'm just driving me fucking crazy. I don't know what is going on right now. I really don't know.
Across the ocean, leaving just a memory. A snapshot in the family album. Daddy, what else did you leave? All in all, you're just another brick in the wall.
Ma'am, open the door right now. Open the fucking door right now, man. We know you're the fucking killer. Don't make us have to force our fucking way in here. Open the fucking door right now. I know she's in here. I know she's in here some fucking where. I'm gonna find her. I know she's in there. Wait. Shh.
Hey everybody, welcome to the Horror Hounds podcast. Usually on this podcast we talk about, you know, horror films and upcoming releases and films. But instead we're going to actually talk about a real killer out there. And she's called the Wrench Killer. Based on the movie The Wrench Killer, you know, a lot of people didn't like this movie, me included. I thought it was pretty stupid. But, you know, there's two people dead now under this person by the name of Amanda Samson. Here's an image of her. You know, on the news, and police is still trying to find her. The police investigator, Detective Powell, investigating the murder, ended up dead and missing. So I don't know what the hell is going on. This killer might be after everybody who's after this movie, trying to shit on this movie. And I don't know really what to do, really. I'm afraid for my life, because I already did a written review on Forbes.com about this movie, saying how it was a stupid movie before the movie's release, because, you know, I get to see films weeks early. I don't know why I get to see movies early, because I'm some kind of critic, and it's not fair to everybody else who gets to see the movie, and, you know, us kind of hurt the movie financially, but I'm sure it'll make money on Blu-ray sales. But yeah, what the fuck is that? Fuck!
Major discovery, who may be the worst serial killer in U.S. history. For murder, the FBI is asking the public for help and information. ABC's Lindsay Davis has the story.
What the fuck? Maybe it was all a dream. Because there's no way that I'm the fucking killer. I knew it. I knew it that I wasn't the fucking killer. Stupid fucking movie. Wow. Can't believe this whole time I thought I was the fucking killer. Maybe it was all a dream. The fucking killer. I knew it. I knew it that it wasn't the fucking killer. Stupid fucking movie. Wow. You're not gonna get away with this fucking asshole.
There's something that I need to tell you. Something I don't think anybody has ever told you once before. I am actually your brother.
You're not my brother.
You probably don't remember because you're separated at birth. But it's true. That's why I have come for you. To tell you that I am your brother. Mother left us both after she killed someone. Don't you see? We're the same. We should be united, all as one big family. So that's why I have come to kill you, so that we can be united.
Oh God, please, no. Just because I like horror films doesn't mean anything. I'm a good person. Please don't kill me, please. Please, please.
It'll be a family reunion.
Hey guys, I just wanted to make this video because I am one of the few, if I think the only survivor that has survived the wrench killer. At first, I thought it was me, but it turns out that was a bad dream and there's actually a real killer out there and I managed to kill him. He dropped his wrench and I managed to pick it up and beat him to death with it. And luckily, I only got out of it with just a few cuts, but I'm luckily alive and I'm very glad that I killed him because now he can't kill anybody else anymore. This person, I don't even know who he was, but he was somebody that was way too obsessed with this movie and was killing people because they were hating on this movie, calling it garbage and worthless and not watchable. And he was killing innocent people because of a movie. And to me, that is very messed up. And I'm glad that I am the one to kill him, and now he's dead and can't be, he won't be killing anybody anytime soon, luckily. I'm just really upset, though, too, because I just found out that people who are my fucking friends, they're fucking dead because of this monster just killing people that were very close to me, that I've done podcasts with, that I've done videos with. Now they're fucking dead, and I'll never get my friends back because this fucking asshole killer killed all my friends. But I guess I could say I got justice, though, because he's dead now.
Goodbye, cruel world, I'm leaving you today. Goodbye, goodbye, goodbye. Goodbye, all you people, there's nothing you can say to make me change my mind. Goodbye.
Kate, on my review of The Wench Killer, I'm sorry, that movie is awful. I mean, did you just hear something? Oh, no, probably nothing. I'm sorry, that movie was downright terrible. Worst horror film ever. I mean, wait, did you guys? No, it's fine, nothing. The fuck? The fuck?
I can't believe I'm still having these dreams.
We don't need no education. We don't need no mind control. No dark sarcasm in the classroom.
going to the movies to see this sequel to The Wrench Killer called, yeah, The Wrench Killer 2. You know, there's a new movie out there. You know, I heard there's a lot of creepy shit that goes on with this movie. But I'm really looking forward to watching this. You know, I heard there's a lot of stuff that goes on with this movie. You know, it's a sequel. I heard there was a real killer out there, but...
So it's been exactly 1 month since I survived the wrench killer, and things have gotten a lot better since then, obviously. I'm not having as many nightmares as I used to have, and it's just, everything's going great. It's a lot of therapy I had, but I'm kind of slowly starting to get back on track. If for some reason the killer does come back after me, I have to remember to not be scared. This time, fight back and never ever think it's over, because it's not. Luckily, I've been kind of not avoiding, but trying to forget all about this. But if he does come back, I'm gonna come back with a vengeance, basically, and I'm not gonna be the wuss that I was first time around. I'm gonna be more prepared and ready to fight back. So I just found out that they're coming out with The Wrench Killer 2, and it's making me very, very nervous just because of what happened when the first one came out. I really hope this one doesn't make anybody crazy like it did with the first one, because with all the destruction and aftermath of the first one that so many people lost their lives, and it's just very unfortunate what happened. I'm one of the lucky few to make it out alive, and I just really, really hope that nothing bad happens this time around. What the fuck? Who's there? Show yourself! I said, who is there? So, this fucking person, I don't know who the fuck it is, but they think that they're pulling some sort of prank or something, because they keep following me around wherever I go. All I was doing was just fucking walking around town, and there's this person walking around following me. And before you say, wasn't there anyone around? No, there wasn't, because it was
friggin', I don't know why there's no one around, but there's this fucking guy thinking that they can scare me because of what happened in the past, and I don't know what to do. I'm just laughing right now because they think that they can just pull this fucking joke on me again when all I want to do is live my life in peace and not have to fucking deal with this wrench killer bullshit again. I had to go through that before with my brother. He said he was my brother. Maybe he was my brother. I really don't know. But if he was my brother, I think that's fucked up that my own flesh and blood decided to fucking try to kill me. And now there's somebody out there that is stalking me, thinking that they could do the same thing again. And I really don't want anybody dying again. So please, guys, please, 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 just watch what you are doing and don't go see this fucking movie. Whoever thought they should make a wrench killer too is fucking crazy, because haven't they read the news? Haven't they watched news, or have they read any articles or anything? They should know that there is a killer out there, or was out there, trying to kill people that were watching this movie and basically shitting on it, and now they're doing the same thing again. Like, what the fuck is wrong with people? Just don't see this movie, please. Whatever you do, do not see this fucking movie. I just don't know what to do right now, because I did call the cops. They fucking laughed at me because they think that I'm just pulling this shit again, even though I was a victim previously, and they think I'm fucking lying and that I'm just trying to get attention this time around when I almost fucking died last time. I almost fucking died. What are you trying to, what the fuck is wrong with you people? Just to warn you guys, anyone going to see this movie, you're probably gonna get killed or attacked, because I keep hearing stuff and seeing things, and I don't know what the fuck is going on, but if you see this movie, I'm warning you right now, something bad is gonna happen, so just be very careful and watch out, please. Ow. Jesus Christ, fucking strong.
Just a brick in the wall. All in all, it was all just bricks in the wall. We don't need no education. We don't need no thought control.
What the fuck? What do you want from me? What do you want? What do you want?
What the fuck? Are you okay?
Oh my God. Thank God. Thank God you're fucking here. Thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you.
Across the ocean.
What the fuck's been going on?
Leaving just a memory. A snapshot in the family album. Daddy, what else did you leave for me?
Daddy, what you leave?
it was all just bricks in the wall.
We don't need no education.
Now there's a killer out there that is alive, but thankfully he is in fucking jail right now, or will be, because he's arrested. Thank God a cop came and saved me. Thank you, thank you, thank you. So why is this happening?
This movie, it really got inside my mind.
Why is this movie doing this to so many people?
I don't know what happened. I was just watching the movie, and then I saw something.
But this needs to end right now. I need to know right now what is going on and why this is happening over and over again. This happened to me once before, and now this is happening to me again. I need you to be honest with me and let me know what is going on and why you are trying to kill me. And just, what is this movie doing to these so many people out there?
You tried to tell me to do something that I didn't want to do. You told me to hurt someone. But I never wanted to hurt anyone. I just couldn't help. I couldn't stop myself.
Just please, 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 just let me know. Just give me an answer. I need closure. I need fucking closure. Just give me an answer.
It might hurt you too. I didn't mean to do this to you.
flown across the ocean. Leaving just a memory. A snapshot in the family album. Daddy, what else did you leave for me? Daddy, what'd you leave behind for me? All in all, it was just a brick in the wall.
Thank God you're fucking here. Thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you.
Across the ocean. What the fuck's been going on?
He is in fucking jail right now. Or will be. Because he's arrested.
Got inside my mind.
Why is this movie doing this to so many people?
I don't know what happened. It might hurt you too.
I don't know what to freaking do anymore. I seriously don't. So, they're making a third movie? A third Wrench Killer movie? After all the shit the first two movies started? I'm starting to lose faith in humanity. I guess one good thing is, at least I still got my dog. I guess that's one good thing. But that's also why I really dread this third movie coming out. Because when this third movie comes out, there's going to be so much more shit going down. There's going to be so much more murders going on. So much other crimes going on that have to involve somebody trying to be the Wrench Killer. I just wish that these movies never would have gotten made.
Because if it wouldn't have ever gotten made, we wouldn't have even had to have been dealing with this bullshit anyway. So like, now what's next? Is it gonna be children who are gonna get killed next? Think about the children. The children are our future. And if something happens to those children, our future is in danger. Think about it. One of those children could possibly change the whole world. Maybe they could discover what happened before the Big Bang, or maybe they could create some new medicine that could revolutionize medicine, or something. If we lose that because of this goddamn movie, I don't even know what to do anymore. Because I've been saying this when the second movie came out. And now again with the third movie, and they're saying, oh, the final chapter. Yeah, they have said that with so many other horror franchises. Like, Friday the 13th, Part 4, the final chapter. Freddy's Dead, the final nightmare. Yeah, right. They say that for marketing. Then I can guarantee you that because, oh, that this third movie was such a big hit, they had to just keep that ball rolling. It's almost like that humanity has become more, like that they've become more aware and more greedy about the money. Like that we care more about the money. A green piece of paper, a green inanimate object that doesn't even care about us, than we do the life of another human being? With all due respect, what the fuck's wrong with society? God, I know you can hear me, but please do something to stop this. Seems like you're the only one now who can stop all this. Because if people aren't going to listen to me, then I don't know what to do anymore. It feels like I'm talking to a brick wall. You are all going to go see the movie anyway because, oh, your friends are going to see it. Yeah? So if your friends told you to go jump off of a cliff, would you do it? Alright, you show yourself, motherfucker. Damn it. I can't remember where I put my goddamn gun. Damn it, where did I? Here we go. Don't fuck with me. The fuck you want, huh? He ain't out there. All right. That's it.
God damn you, witch before I die, tell me, please, why? Why? That's all I want to know is why. I've been trying to help you. That's all I'm trying to do. was trying to help.
Why am I doing this to so many people? It makes me just want to kill myself. I have to stop myself before I hurt any more people. It has to be done.
Leave behind for me. the wall. All in all, it was all just bricks in the wall.
We don't need no education. We don't need no mind control. No
Goodbye, cruel world, I'm leaving you today. Goodbye, goodbye, goodbye. Goodbye, all you people. There's nothing you can say to make me change my mind. Goodbye. Thank you.
Thank you.